I've created a little outline here to show how the bullets and numbering outline works. Under the first level, there's one. I've got the United States, the country. And then we have two, Australia, another country. And then three, Turkey, a country. Underneath there, on the 1.1 level, we've got Michigan, a state. 1.2, Texas, a state. And then under that, we've got cities within the state, within the country. Normally, when you click on a bullets and numbering section, your bullets and numbering toolbar will appear. If you close it while you're in that section, when you click back on that section, it does not appear. You'll need to go into your view, toolbars, bullets and numbering. And that brings it right back. Now let's take a look at the bullets and numbering toolbar. We're going to look at this far right bullets and numbering button. But before we do, I want to make sure I'm on this state level. So I'm clicking here. I can see my cursor flickering right next to Michigan. So I'm on my second level, or my 1.1 level. When I click on bullets and numbering, then we're going to the far left tab, bullets. And I want to make, instead of the 1.1, I want to see a square there. So I'm going to click on this square, large, solid, and clicking OK. Turns not only Michigan into a square, but Texas, California. So all my states are squares, but nothing else. The others stayed the same. Now I'm still on the Michigan paragraph, or part of this outline. Clicking this bullets and numbering again. This time I'm going to go to the graphics, and I'm going to choose one of these graphics. Maybe one of these balls here. Clicking OK does the same thing, but now I've got a graphic showing, but it still only affects that level I was on. And I can change level one to something different if I'd like. Let's go back and make that one a bullet. We'll make that one an arrow. Clicking OK. So now this one's arrows, and level two is the graphic ball. We also want to note what it did with the numbering on our city. Now we only have the one and the two showing our cities. If we change this arrow back, we see the one, the dot, dot. So it doesn't have a number for this second position, so it put dot dot in there. And if I undo that one as well, we see that we're back to having all the numbers. But when I change this to a character or to a graphic, we lose the numbering system on the lower level below it. Now let me go up to my top level here, and I want to change my numbering type to something, say maybe the one right parent. Clicking OK turns them into one right parent. But what happens when I do that on our third level down? Will it keep the numbering system? Let's make these little Roman numerals. And it does. We have our one, and then we've got our dot dot. So if we change our middle level here to a number, we will make that one A. The capital letter A. So now it says 1AI, because we've got our A and our 1. And it's putting our pair, our like right parent after the A instead of just the 1. So it that rolls down as well.